Ashley here, and I'm here with video 2 from my new doll series. I'm sharing some of my personal collection that are not Reborn related dolls. And we've all heard the story, no matter where in the world you come from, I'm pretty sure this is a universal story, and that is the story of Little Red Riding Hood. It's a classic children's story. I'm pretty sure all children grow up knowing about this story. It's also, I believe it was originated, the original story wasn't so childlike, it's actually kind of gruesome, but I enjoy all versions of the story. The story holds a lot of meaning, I think, because it teaches several different types of morals. One moral that comes to mind is taking care of your elders. You know, Little Red Riding Hood was sent to bring goodies of hospitality to her sick grandmother. So, you know, taking care of your elders is really important, especially in this day and age, getting old. I take care of the elderly. I know it is really important to have that support system of people to come and help you when you're in need. And just to know that you're cared about. Another moral is do not talk to strangers. This is really important for children, which is, I think, why a lot of parents share the story with their children. Because yeah, this wolf, she fell victim to this wolf who not only wanted her basket of goodies, but also wanted her. And in this day and age, it is a very scary world out there, and it's very important to teach your children, do not talk to strangers. This little girl, Red Riding Hood, was way too quick to tell this wolf where she was going. And a lot of different stories tell different versions of the tale that she was followed to her grandmother's house. The original story was she was not followed. The wolf went ahead of her, and so she obviously divulged way too much information. This is probably a moral that I didn't take very seriously. When I first joined this community, I may have given out too much information to certain people, so I am not happy with giving that information. Now that I look back on it, there are certain people I wish did not have my address, for one. Lesson learned. So I'm gonna share this doll with you guys. I'm really excited. She is super cute, super interesting. She is from, I don't know the exact date, I want to say 1975, because there's nothing on her that I can find that is marked, but I did find others similar to her style. Here she is. This is Little Red Riding Hood. Isn't she darling? She is wearing this red cape that her grandmother made her in the original story. Her grandmother had made her this red cape. She has little arms here. So she's wearing this red cape with a matching red dress. She's got her little red hat. Her face is painted. It's paint on cloth. Have matching eyebrows, that's funny. And she has blonde hair, super cute. What makes this doll so special in my mind is that she is a topsy-turvy doll. Topsy-turvy dolls were, I think, most popular between the 60s and 90s. I haven't really come across too many dolls, you know, that were earlier than that. I'm sure topsy-turvy dolls were popular since before dolls were even a thing. So you can still get topsy-turvy dolls. I looked on Walmart. Everyone is accessible to nowadays, really. Walmart, online, they sell topsy-turvy puppet dolls, all sorts of different things. So what the topsy-turvy means is that if you were to flip Miss Riding Hood upside down, she turns into the grandmother. How cute is that? So this is Red Riding Hood's grandmother. She also has a painted face. So endearing. There's just so much personality to these little dolls. Her dress is, it's not actually patchwork, but it is a patchwork print. She has this silk and lace apron. And she's wearing this cute little bonnet. So yeah, I really love this doll. And this doll also has an extra feature. And that feature is that if you turn the doll around, it just looks like the back of a doll. What is so special about that? Well, you also have the wolf when you flip the hat up. So this is the grandma wolf. Oh, there's the little eyes. Let me see. Now these aren't just some glue-on googly eyes, even though they look like googly eyes. They're actually buttons. The black inside is sewn on into the material, and then the white part is separate. As I'm looking from the side, you guys probably won't be able to see it, but they're separate pieces. It's super cute. So furry face, little wolf. So this doll I think would be great for children, because I think that's why they originally made for like storytelling, like puppeteering. You have just this one doll and you're able to tell the entire story, which is really exciting. I have not shown my goddaughter Serena. She's probably still on the youngish side. She's going to be 3 in March, but I really plan on telling her the story of Little Red Riding Hood. She's just approaching that age where she already knows about stranger danger and stuff like that. And she comes along with me to work a lot of times. I'd say at least twice a week she'll come with me, and she will take part and have responsibility in helping my elderly clients. Not only is that good for her and her character building and her knowing, you know, there are some people in this world that need our help, but it also gives a childlike spirit to my clients as well, because most of their days are pretty grim, you know, very boring. So they love seeing my goddaughter. So yeah, that's my little story of my topsy-turvy vintage Red Riding Hood grandma and wolf. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing her. She is kind of creepy, but I love her. She came from my grandmother's collection and I just adore her. Yeah, I hope you guys did too. Talk to y'all later, guys. Have a blessed day.